Can you give me a quick recap? What do you mean by earthen dams? Have you visited any earthen dams? Anyone? Have you visited earthen dams? Have you seen the earthen dams? Hemant Thakur?
नाही सर.
विजिट नाही केलंय. ओके, कुठल्या डॅमला विजिट केलंय?
ग्रॅव्हिटी डॅमला बघितलं होतं सर.
ओके, व्हॉट यू हॅव सीन? येस, which type of dam you have seen? What are the various structures you have seen? Just quick recap. No idea? Yes. So today we will start unit number 4, that is earthen dam and diversion headworks. What do you mean by earthen dam and diversion headworks? So earthen dam means what? As the name suggests, a dam constructed with the help of locally available earth. Locally available earth. That's why the dam is called as earthen dam. It is totally made up of earth. Correct? So what are the various contents of this unit? That is introduction. What are the various conditions for favoring the earthen dam? What are the limitations? How the earthen dams is classified? Then components of earthen dam. Then what are the various requirements for safe design of earthen dam? And most important part of the earthen dam is that seepage analysis. Seepage analysis. So we will see the seepage analysis also. Then what are the various methods for carrying out the seepage analysis, that is critical circle method. Then stability analysis of foundation, and what are the modes of failure of earthen dam, that we will discuss. Then part B of unit number 4 is diversion headwork. What do you mean by diversion headwork? It is the structure constructed within the dam or near the dam for diverting the water from the dams to the canal. So it is called as diversion headworks. So what are the function of diversion headwork? How we can select the site for diversion headwork? Layout of diversion headwork. Then design of weir on permeable foundation. Then Khosla's theory. Then Blythe's lane theory. That is a brief introduction that we will discuss in unit number 4, part B. Okay. Yes, any doubt, any difficulty? Am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are the contents of unit number 4. So let us discuss what are the learning objectives of unit number 4. After learning unit number 4, what you will get, or what things you will get learn. So what are the learning objective of unit number 4? First is types of earth dam. What are the various types of or classification of earth dam you will come to know? Then what are the causes of failure and criteria for safe design of earthen dam? This is the second learning objective. Then third is section of an earthen dam. How we can design the section of an earthen dam? Fourth and important parameter in case of earthen dam is that seepage analysis and seepage control measure. As we know that earthen dam is constructed with the help of locally available material or earth. That's why it is susceptible to the seepage. So we have to carry out seepage analysis and seepage control measures. And fifth one is divergent headwork structure. Means after learning, after studying unit number 4, you will get to learn the divergent headwork structure. What is the divergent headwork structure? Objective, importance, types, classification, and layout. So these are 5 learning objective of unit number 4. So first of all, earthen dam. Yes, earthen dam. It is an embankment can be easily constructed on earth foundation with natural material with minimum processing and limited equipments. So name suggests earthen dam is a locally available material or earth that we can use for constructing the dam. These dams are constructed from earthen materials such as gravel, sand, silt and clay. Gravel, sand, silt and clay, which is locally available. Are you getting me? Yes?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So earthen dam is constructed with the help of locally available material with a less equipment we are having. Next is, yes, what are the various conditions which are favoring to the construction of earthen dam? Which are the conditions which favors the construction of earthen dam? When we go for earthen dam, so the first condition is when funding is low, means lack of funds. Since we know that in case of gravity dam, we already discussed in unit number 2, gravity dam. In case of gravity dam, the costing is very high, funds are available, requirement is very high. But if the funds are less, then we go for earthen dam. When foundation strut, means that is the support, is not sufficiently strong. This is the second condition. Please note down. Please note down. First one is, what are the various conditions favoring the construction of earthen dam? The first is when funding is low. Second is when the foundation strut is not sufficiently strong. Then third one is when sufficient spillway space is not available in case of a narrow valley. In case of a narrow valley areas where there is no sufficient space is available for a spillway, because we know that in case of gravity dam, we are providing a spillway. When the spillway space is not available, then we go for earthen dam. This is the third condition which favors the construction of earthen dam. Next, fourth is when there is a availability of local material and sufficient quarry material near the dam site. Okay. And last one is if the river is perennial. So these are some of the conditions which are helpful or which decides, or we can say that which favors the condition of favoring on earthen dam. So first is funding, if funding is low. Second one is foundation support is less, sufficient strong foundation is not available, sufficient space is not available for spillway. And fourth one, when there is a availability of local ample, locally available or quarry material is available. And last one is if the river is perilinear. Over. Have you note down? Yes, Swaranjali. Have you note down the condition favoring?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Shall I move forward further? So then next is, what are the limitations? As we know that the earthen dam is constructed with the help of locally available material or locally available soil or earth. So what are the various limitations of the construction of earthen dam that we have to discuss? since it is constructed with the help of locally available soil or material, this earthen dam is susceptible to the leakages. So what are the limitations of earthen dam? Note down. First, an earthen dam is easily damaged or destroyed by water flowing on or over against it. Whenever the water is over top, then the earthen dam can be easily damaged or destroyed. So this is the very important. In case of earthen dam, we never allow the water to flow over the dam. But in case of gravity dam, we can allow the water to flow over the gravity dam because it is constructed with the help of concrete. It is a concrete structure. Gravity dam is a concrete structure. But in case of earthen dam, we never permit or never allow the water to flow over the earthen dam because it is constructed with the help of soil. Suppose during the rainy season, during the flood occurs, and if the earthen dam get overtopped, then definitely it will get fail or damage easily or destroyed easily. This is the major limitation of earthen dam. Second, if it is not adequately compacted during construction, the dam will have weak structure prone to seepage. During the construction, if you are not compacting the earth properly with the help of compacting equipment, then there may be the voids in the structure of earthen dam, and due to that voids, there may be the seepage or leakage, and which is a cause of failure of earthen dam. So adequate compaction is required during the construction of earthen dam. And third limitation, that is, since it is made up of a soil, it requires a continuous maintenance to prevent erosion, tree growth, because soil is there, then it may happen that the dam, within the dam body, some trees may grow, insects may damage, there are some of the burrowing insects or animals which will cause the leakage of earthen dam. So the earthen dam requires continuous maintenance. See, in case of a gravity dam, we require a less maintenance because it is a concrete structure. But in case of earthen dam, we require a continuous maintenance. Monitoring and maintenance is required. So the maintenance cost is very high in case of earthen dam. Construction cost is less, but the maintenance cost is very high. Whereas in case of gravity or concrete dam, the initial construction cost is more and maintenance cost is less. So these are three limitations of earthen dam. First one is it can be easily damaged by overtopping. If it is not adequately compacted, then it will lead to the seepage failure. And third is it requires continuous maintenance. So high maintenance cost. Clear? Yes, any doubt? Any difficulty, Pratiksha?
Pradula?
Samastai? Okay. So what we have seen? We have seen a definition of earthen dam. What are the conditions favoring the construction of earthen dam? And third, today's point of discussion is limitation of earthen dam. So these are the points we have covered so far. Now let us move towards next topic, that is types of earthen dam. What are the various types of earthen dams are there? So first is homogeneous embankment type, means what? A continuous single material we are using. Second, zone embankment type, means we are using a different materials and we are making the zones within the body of dam. And third one is diaphragm type. An impervious diaphragm is made to arrest the entry or arrest the seepage of water within the body of a dam. So these are the three types of earthen dams generally we construct. First is homogeneous. Second one is zone embankment type. And third one is diaphragm type. Let us discuss one by one. So first is homogeneous embankment type. please draw the figure. I will give you 1 minute to draw the figure. Give the title, homogeneous embankment type, and draw the figure. I will give you 1 minute. After you finish, tell me. Yes, we J145 roll number. J145 roll number. Over, figure is over. Vaishali Patil. Aniket.
Yes, sir.
Okay, show me. I have drawn the figure. Put on your video. Show me the figure. Vaishali, I am not able to see your figure. I have drawn the figure of homogeneous embankment type of dam. Pratiksha, figure zali ka kadun? Pratiksha, Ankit, Aniket.
Yes, sir, चालू है.
Okay. Fast. So that we can discuss what are the various silent features of homogeneous type of embankment type of dam, earthen dam. Once you finish, show me the figure. Put on your videos on. Show me your notebook. Yes, Pratiksha.
Yes, sir.
I am not able to see the figure that you have drawn.
Yes, sir. One.
Vaishali. Vaishali, zali ka figure kadun. Okay, very good. So this is first category, that is homogeneous embankment type of earthen dam. So we will discuss the features of homogeneous type of embankment type of earthen dam. Now you can see over here the whole body of a dam is made up of a single material, homogeneous embankment without any internal drainage system is provided. Slope pitching is provided on the upstream side so that we can stable the upstream side slope. This is the seepage line we are getting. Water may get seeped through the body of a earthen dam. And this is the impervious foundation. Correct? So what are the silent features? So first is constructed with uniform and homogeneous material. Single material is used for the construction of homogeneous embankment type of earthen dam. Suitable for low height dams up to 10 meters. Suppose the height of dam is up to 10 meters, then only we go for this type of dam. Usually constructed with the soil and grit mixed in proper proportion. Next, the seepage action of such dams are not favorable. Therefore, for safety in case of rapid drawdown, the upstream slope is kept relatively flat. See, you can see this upstream slope. Upstream side slope is kept relatively flat because if so, suppose there is a sudden drawdown condition is occur, then it may not get wash away the upstream slope. So for preventing the washing of upstream side during the sudden drawdown condition, we will keep the slope of upstream side as a nearly flat with pitching of a stone. Sometimes homogeneous section is modified by constructing a rock toe at the downstream lower end and providing a horizontal filter drain. Now see, sometimes I will show you. Sometimes see, this is the toe portion. This is the toe portion. Here some horizontal filter is provided. Horizontal filter is constructed. That we will see in the next slide or next type of earthen type embankment type of dam. So sometimes horizontal filter is provided near the toe. Yes, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So homogeneous embankment, single material is used that we have seen. It is used suitable for height up to 10 meter, usually constructed with soil and grit. For during sudden drawdown condition, there should not be washing of the upstream material. That's why we will keep the upstream slope as 3:1. Sometimes filter is provided on the downstream side near the toe. This is the simplest type of earthen embankment. See, these are the silent features or characteristics you might have been seen. Now, see, this is the another figure that I have already told you that some drainage filter is provided near the toe. This is the drainage filter. Sometimes a drainage filter is provided near the toe so that we can arrest the entry of seepage from upstream side to downstream side. So these are the drainage filters provided. If we are not providing the drainage filter, then what will happen, that this seepage line will go up and up like this. This seepage line will go up and up like this, and water flowing continuously, water is flowing, and due to that, what will happen, this portion may get eroded and dam may get filled. So to arrange the entry of seepage line or exit of seepage line on the downstream side, some sort of drainage filter is provided. Drainage filter means it is some sort of porous material is used. Porous material is used, and due to that porosity of material, the water will easily seep through that drainage filter and it will not harm the body of a dam. It can be easily discharge drain on the downstream side. But if drainage filter is not provided in case of homogeneous embankment type of earthen dam, then what will happen? This is the path or flow of water on the downstream side, and due to that, this material may get saturated and it may get filled. It may get filled and dam may get break. So to avoid this situation, sometimes homogeneous embankment type of earthen dam is provided with drainage filter. Correct? See, homogeneous section is generally added with horizontal drainage filter, rock, toe, etc. Due to that, what will happen? Internal drainage system keeps the ferritic line well within the body of a dam and steeper slope. Thus, smaller section can be used. By providing the drainage filter, we can construct a dam with smaller section. If we are not providing a drainage filter, then in case of homogeneous dam, we require a huge section. Huge material section is required for homogeneous embankment type. If we want to reduce the section of a homogeneous type of earthen dam, then we go for drainage filter. Internal drainage is always provided in almost all types of embankment. Now next is zone embankment type. Last 10 minutes to go. Zone embankment type earthen dam. Please draw the figure. I will give you 2 minutes to draw the figure, zone embankment type. Give the title and draw the figure. हर्षवर्धन हरीश फिगर काढून झाली का
नाही
अजिंक्य
हो सर
फिगर काढा व्यवस्थित वी आर हॅविंग 3 types ऑफ अर्धन डॅम ऍट लीस्ट यू आर एबल टू ड्रॉ द फिगर अँड देन यू कॅन इझिली राईट डाऊन द डिस्क्रिप्शन Last 7 minutes to go. Over. Ajinkya झाली का फिगर काढून हरीश
झाली
Now see in case of zone embankment type you can see there are various zones This is the central zone or impervious core, and there is a pervious outer zone. There are two types of zones are provided. In between central core and pervious outer zone, there is a transition filter of moderate permeability material is there. So there are three materials we are using. First is impervious core for central core material. After that, we are providing a transition filter with moderate permeability material. And outer layer, that is a pervious outer zone. So there are various zones. Hence, it is called as a zone embankment type earthen dam. Zone embankment type earthen dam. Slope protection is provided on the upstream side with the help of stones. You might have been seen that stone pitching is there. जर तुम्ही एखाद्या धरणाला भेट दिली असेल, in that case, you might have been seen the slope protection work. That is nothing but stone pitching is there. Stone pitching is there. So what are the features, silent features of zone embankment type earthen dam? Usually provided with central impervious core that you might have been already seen. Covered comparatively pervious transition zone, which finally surrounded by much more pervious outer zone. So there are three zones, impervious, moderate permeability zone, and then pervious outer zone. The transition zone prevents piping through cracks, which may develop in the core. See, suppose in case of homogeneous embankment type earthen dam, you might have been already seen, in case of homogeneous type of embankment type of a dam, single material is there, and due to that seepage is there like this, correct? And due to that, what will happen, that piping is there. Piping means what? There is a small tunnel like structures will be created within the body of a dam, and due to that water will seep within that channels. That is called as piping. It may be the within the body of a dam, or it may be below the body of a dam. Some small tunnels are developed and water will flow out in case of homogeneous type of embankment. But to avoid the seepage, there is another modification, another type of embankment type of earthen dam is developed, and that is called as a zone. In case of zone embankment type, we are providing a impervious central core, over that a moderate permeability material is placed, and over that pervious outer zone is placed. So due to that, what will happen? See, transition zone prevents piping through the cracks which may be developed in the core. The outer zone gives stability to the central pervious field and also distribute the load over the larger area. See, outer zone, what is the function of outer zone in case of zone embankment type of earthen dam? To distribute the area, distribute the load over the larger area. That is the function of outer zone, pervious outer zone, to distribute the load over the larger area. And central core checks the seepage. What is the function of central core? To check the seepage. And middle portion, that is moderate pervious zone, it will moderately allow the water to seep on the downstream side. So these are the function of all three zones. This is, so transition filters are provided between inner zone and outer zone, that you might have been seen in the figure. Sometimes, see, this is the filter. Transition filters are provided. Transition filter always provided whenever there is an abrupt change in permeability from one zone to another zone. Now third, that is diaphragm type. So last 1.5 minutes to go. Please draw the figure. We will continue discussing the characteristics of diaphragm type embankment in the next lecture. Please draw the figure. Last 1 minute to go. After 1 minute, our lecture will end. And we will stop over there. And we will continue tomorrow. So please draw the figure. We will continue in tomorrow's class. So please draw the figure, diaphragm type embankment dam. Our lecture will end within 1 minute. Please try to draw the figure and we will continue tomorrow.